members of St. John's friends. I don't know about you, but I love to sing. I've always loved to sing. My older sister Joanne was already a member of the St. Barnabas Anglican Church Choir when I too joined at about age 7. I remember on Thursday evenings how Mr. Cowper, I'm sure he was a kind and probably wonderful man, but he inspired some terror in us children by having each of us stand in turn and sing a scale for him. And sometimes we had to sing it a couple of times in order to please him. We knew right then that singing in church was serious business and that it required nothing less than our very best efforts. Of course, the rewards were great also. And my love for church music today, I'm sure, was nurtured and inspired by my participation in that ensemble, even at a young age. So thanks to Mr. Cowper. I don't know whether you sing in a choir today, have never sung in a choir, or wish you sang in one. I do hope that you will join us on Sunday afternoon, December 13th at 4:30. To sing with other members of St. John's, and I think with some friends and folks from around the world, literally, to enjoy an afternoon singing familiar Advent and Christmas music. You'll be able to sing your heart out, and no one else will hear you, other than members of your household, if they're at home with you at that time. Gordon gave me a little sneak preview of what we're going to be enjoying on Sunday, earlier this week, and I can only say that I am really looking forward to it. We're in for a wonderful special treat, and I know that our choir has been working furiously hard at preparing for this. I hope you'll join us Sunday afternoon. And as we sing those familiar carols and you hear that music on the radio in the weeks approaching Christmas, I hope that sometimes you'll take the time to offer a verse, either sung aloud or in the quiet of your mind, as a prayer. One of those familiar hymns, Joy to the World, or O Come All Ye Faithful. And there are times when it's hard to find words to pray, and music and hymnody has always been a way of connecting the faithful with God. So perhaps offer one of those as a prayer. And maybe that will be even more so the case if you're finding the time long or difficult or really missing things that we're not able to do this Christmas because of the pandemic. In any event, I hope to see you here on Sunday morning if you're able to join us, and Sunday afternoon by Zoom. I look forward to that opportunity to sing together with you then. Until then, bye for now.
Well, our musical guest this week is my friend Michelle Gott, who's a fabulous harpist and superb person. So welcome, Michelle.
Hi.
So,
hello, everybody.
I have a question for you. Why the harp? Why, of all the fabulous instruments in the world, do you play the harp?
My first answer is that I was brainwashed, but no, my mom was a harpist, and I mean, I did grow up with harps. I was just surrounded by them, really. She was also a dealer for Lyon and Healy in Las Vegas, so really, my house was full of harps. And I don't know, I mean, I definitely was drawn to the harp from a young age, but I was also exposed for it from a very young age. I was serious about piano probably more than the harp, but then something flipped when I don't know, became a teenager, and I realized like there was so much potential for the harp, that the way you could go in a career was just all these, you know, different pathways, and that really excited me. I also had some really great mentors in high school. I went to Interlaken and kind of lit a fire, and I thought, you know what, I think I can do this. For real.
Well, that's brilliant. Well, and you really have done it. Now, listen, you've got connections all over the world. As you say, you're from Las Vegas. You now live in Ottawa, but you are professor of harp at the University of Arizona in Tucson. How's this pandemic working out for you?
Yeah, it's been crazy. I mean, yes, I grew up in Las Vegas, and then I moved to New York City for school, and I was there for 8 years, and then I moved to Canada, and I lived full-time in Canada for 7 years, and then I got a position in Tucson in 2018, but my partner lives in Ottawa, and I'm a dual citizen, so we were doing that kind of back and forth cross-border relationship thing, which doesn't really work during a pandemic. So, and because of the situation in the US, there really hasn't been a lot of in-person anything at the university. So I adjusted all of my teaching to be remote, at least for this semester. And actually, it's been going very well through a combination of better technology for online lessons, including microphones and different camera angles, as well as asking my students to do a lot of self-reflection through recordings, videos, audio and video. And then, of course, I will review them as well. We've really had a productive semester. I'm not saying that should be the total way of the future, but there are certainly tools that we have acquired during this time that I'm grateful for. So
well, that's
even though
fantastic.
We're all,
I love that you're here in Ottawa teaching in Arizona at the same time. It's unbelievable. Here's Michelle Gott playing the interlude from The Ceremony of Carols by Benjamin Britten.
Can I say something too?
Yes.
I just wanted to thank you so much for giving me the space to record that in the church. It was just such a wonderful experience to leave my house and go and play in a different space, and to know that that music would eventually reach different communities. So I recorded it for you and also for a benefit in Tucson. So it's just a crazy way of kind of connecting a lot of worlds of mine that I love, and I really appreciate the opportunity to do this with you.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you. That's great.